Hello, welcome to this channel. Thanks for being here. Today I'm gonna make a quick video about two or three things I'm working on. First of all, I'd like to introduce properly this new frame I designed a few weeks ago, which is the Pickle R3 frame intended for racing. I already showed the design on Facebook, on Instagram, on things like that, and it's published on Thingiverse as well, but I didn't make any proper introduction for what I'm building here. And I also like you to introduce this new stack I got from Flywoo. I bought it on their site because it seems quite interesting for this build, so I'm gonna discuss about it a bit later. The frame itself is a 3-inch squish X or wide X frame layout with the side plates. I wanted to mess up a bit with the side plates designs, so I went with the thing that is not so commonly spread or seen as a design, which is a back mounted camera. I've done this primarily for camera protection because being very very up and rear, it's less prone to take a front hit, and maybe it's not so true, but quite likely. It also allows one to give it a very high angle, so if you're racing with such a frame, you can go with a camera angle of 50, I think, or 55, which is quite high, and essentially for fun. So the frame is built with several components, which are the base plate you have here and the two side plates that simply attach to the frame via some little slots, and using 15 millimeter standoffs, which are nylon standoffs because you don't find quite easily, I find none, aluminium standoff for that. The design quite simple. It fits, I think, two layered electronic components. So basically, you can put a big stack in this build. But if you have a flight controller and a VTX put on top, it's sufficient. And I haven't designed it yet, but you can put some kind of cover here, blocked on the standoffs, which can personalize the design and the frame. I went with some Spintech motors, 1304, not so common because they're not very widely distributed, but it seemed to be an interesting motor for 3 or 4S setups. Quite powerful. Haven't tested it yet. I think it's 8 grams, so it's not on the light side of the motors, but you have extra thrust that could compensate that. You could go with classic motors for this frame, like the 1204, 1303, or even bigger 1404 or such motors. And that's about it. The frame itself has the USB cut for the facing down USB. You'll see that in fact it's quite important for the gear I choose to put on it, and it also have the twist lock mechanism that I put on some older Pickle frames. I borrowed it from a guy whose name is Di Alexi. Finnish guy that designs a lot of stuff on frames, and it's quite convenient. I think you saw it at some moment on the Twig frames, The goal is just to put an adapter on the battery and twist the battery to hold it in place. For a racing setup could be interesting because practically you can swap very fast the batteries if you want, but you can also use some rubber band to secure the battery as on classical setups. So that's it for the frame. Now let's talk about the flight controller and the VTX. So I got from Flywoo website. So I bought it. I didn't get it for review or something like that. I bought it because I found it interesting. This flight controller and the VTX. The flight controller itself have some interesting features and some weird features, let's say. It's a classic and now common toothpick style layout with motor pads on the sides and a lot of pads on the top of the controller, which are quite convenient. But only it has the facing down USB port. So if you plan to use it on a toothpick or pickle pick setup, pickle pick is fine, but on a toothpick you have to flip it over. And so you cannot access all the connectors from the top, so it can be an issue, but not that much. In my particular case, it's not an issue because I put the slot to get the USB facing down. Some other interesting characteristics are the fact that it have 13 amps ESCs, which is quite nice. And it also have a memory chip for the black box, which is not that common for such I/O controllers. It also have a barometer, BMP 280, not so common as well, and four LEDs. Which are practically addressable because they are the WS 2812, which is the common LED type you use on FPV quads, that you can change the color depending on different events and triggers you program. I haven't tested yet. I have to put it, and I also like the fact that it have full holes, so basically it will stay more securely in place in the setup. It won't pop out, find any chance to pop out, because the holes are totally full, and you put the grommet in it and hold it tightly. In this combo you also have all the screws, cap, battery lead you need, grommets, spacers, nuts and basically all you need to mount it. And I also ordered the Goku VTX that goes with it, and not only with it, because this VTX is quite cool. As you can see, you have several hole options, so basically you can fit it on a 16 by 16 millimeter stack, 20 by 20 millimeter stack, and whoop 26 millimeter board. Depending what you use, you can break it and keep only the small part. It goes up to 450 milliwatts, I think, or 425, I don't remember exactly. You have access to the LEDs because it have as well four LEDs, so you can connect it to flight controller and have a lot of LEDs, so for a racing setup it may be cool. And you have external control from the FC. The only thing that maybe is a bit inconvenient for me or for such setups is that you are supposed to mount it like this, so the antenna you may have a problem to hold it in place firmly. So I don't know, maybe I am going to put some heat shrink, put the antenna here and put some piece of heat shrink here to secure the antenna down. it's a bit about above 1 gram, so it's quite light. So see you next time for the full build and full assembly and flight footage to see how that thing goes. Anyway, nice gear. Hope everything is going to run fine and don't have an issue. I also use those HQ tree blades, 2.5 inch pitch. I don't have the Kebabs Gemfan tree blades yet. They're due to arrive, but for now I use this one. And I use a crossfire with the mini mortality antenna that I don't have here, but I'm going to use it. So let me know what you think about this setup. It should be pretty fast, not the lightest one possible, but it could run on 3 or 4S, so it may compensate a bit of weight and allows one to go fast and race it quite nicely. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye, see you next time.